Hello everyone, welcome to Slayer Tips and Tricks episode 4, and today we're going to be killing steel dragons. So on screen now, as usual, is information about steel dragons. Quite a bit more to take in than the previous tasks, but obviously pause the video now if you need to read over that. What I'm also going to start doing is adding another clip like this one on screen now, which tells you the quests that are going to be needed for the access to where I kill steel dragons. So the quests you're going to need are the Tale of the Musfa and the Temple at Senestan. I've also added two quests that are not needed to get to steel dragons, but they'll save you a hell of a lot of time getting to steel dragons. I would recommend completing Fairy Tale Part 2 so you can access the fairy rings. Other than that, then Love Story for the Relica Teleport tabs would be the best option for you. Right, so after that super long intro, you want to start off at preferably the Grand Exchange with all what you're going to be taking to steal dragons in your inventory and teleports out of where you're going to be killing them. I start at the GE and I run to the fairy ring that's located between Edgeville and the Grand Exchange. I use that to go to Zanaris, that's the one, and we're going to be using the main fairy ring, which enables us to teleport around Runescape via fairy ring codes. So you want to enter the combination of DKS into your fairy ring, and this will take you to the top of a mountain in Relica. If you're familiar with Ice Strike Worms, you will use that code a lot whilst on Ice Strike Worm tasks. So as you can see, I get ambushed by Haiti, which was not obviously expected, but in a few weeks time, Hattie will no longer be there, so you don't have to worry about that. So you want to run north off that mountain and then run northwest. And if you complete the Tale of Musfa quest, you shall see a travel icon on your minimap where you'll see a log. You'll take that log and you'll be on a random island which is near the wilderness. But don't worry, you're not going to be in the wilderness while killing steel dragons. So once off that log, you want to run east, and then you'll see a passageway forming with a frozen block in the way. Right, to get past this ice block or frozen block, you need to have completed the Temple at Sinistine quest, and once completed that quest, you'll be familiar with heat globes, and you can see the pedestal there glowing away as I've activated a heat globe on the top of it, which enables me to get past the frozen blocks. Now once past, you want to pot up with your super anti-fire or anti-fire potions, and you want to drink a super attack strength, an overload, or extreme attack and strength. You want to run north, just behind the temple itself, place your cannon on what seems the edge of Runescape, and you want to start firing your cannon, have your auto-retaliate on or off, depends what you prefer. I prefer off because I bank the bones of my pack yak, and it just saves me running around when I've got auto-retaliate on, when I'm being attacked by steel dragons when I'm trying to pick up my drops. You may be wondering why I'm using a Dragon Defender and not an Anti-Dragon Fire Shield or a Dragon Fire Shield to kill steel dragons. This is because I'm currently under the effect of a super anti-fire potion, which enables me to kill any sort of dragon without the specific shield needed. The super anti-fire potion requires a herbal level of 85 to make. And once made, it cannot be traded with other players or sold in the Grand Exchange. It's just specifically for your use only. Now, if you don't have a herb lore level of 85 and you cannot pot that herb level to 85 because your herb lore level is too low, then the other alternative, and it's a definite alternative, would be using an anti-dragon fire shield or a dragon fire shield along with the standard anti-fire potion, which is buyable from the GE, and it costs about 3,000 to 4,000 gold coins. Right, so we're coming to the end of the video now, and I'm going to end up concluding it now. So this steel dragon task is a good money maker if you decide to bank the bones. If you don't bank the bones, then it's not an issue, but you're just losing out on, I'd say, about 500k. If you like to AFK slayer tasks, then I wouldn't recommend AFKing steel dragons, because you've got a lot to think about, like your cannon decaying and your anti-fire running out. Also, being lord to the east of where we are now, there are iron dragons located there, and you don't want to be killing them unless assigned them. Right, so we're coming to the end now of Slayer Tips and Tricks episode 4. Be free to post a comment on the video and give me some feedback, and I'll try and develop it from there. Other than that, thanks for watching, guys. Have a nice day and take care.